If you're building in Airtable and have never really linked tables before, you're gonna feel at a disadvantage. And so in this video, I'm gonna be breaking down for you all the different types of linked tables that you might consider. That way you can build the best thing for your needs in Airtable. So if learning more about linking tables in Airtable is of interest to you, stick around and let's get into it. Welcome back to the channel. If you're new here, my name is Gareth, and this is Gap Consulting. It's my mission here to help you get the full potential out of no-code tools like Airtable, and in this video, I'm going to be diving into table linking for beginners. Now, before we get into the heart of the video, I first want to invite you to join me for some free training. If you're kind of new to Airtable, or maybe you just need a refresher, my Airtable Crash Course is going to teach you all the basics so that you can truly master everything that Airtable has to offer. Grab that crash course for free at gapconsulting.io/airtable-crash-course. But without further ado, let's hop on into the heart of the video. We're talking about linking tables. Now, before we get into the actual linking itself, first we need to make sure that we understand what exactly tables are. Because if you haven't built tables appropriately, then none of the linking is really going to make any sense. So tables in Airtable, I have three of them here. They are the tabs up at the top of our data layer. So I'm in the data layer of Airtable. I prefer to build from this place, although you can build from interfaces as well. So I'm back here, I've got the table 1, 2, and 3. Each table represents its own set of data. So as an example, you might have contacts in your database, it's pretty common. You might have transactional data, so every single transaction. You might have projects, you might have tasks. The point is, a table represents a data set, and everything within the table is a new element or a new record of that data set. So if you bring in a new contact, you make a new contact out in the world, you would want to add them to your sales CRM. Of course, you will add a record of that person in your contacts table, as an example. So that is first and foremost, we need to understand that a table in Airtable represents a set of data. Now, once we've understood what a table is, it's going to make more sense when we go to link them. Because naturally, for example, if you had contacts and you had transactions, you're going to want to connect those things because transactions don't happen in a vacuum. People will not just give you money and anonymously. So you will want to connect it to the person who actually created or completed the transaction. And so that's where linking things comes into play. So for us, we have table 1 and table 2 here, and I'm going to simulate a few different types of links. Now, when you link two things, first you would start by adding a new field in one of the two tables, and then you create a link to another record. Now, assuming that you already have the tables established, you'll see them listed out here. I have 1, 2, and 3. Not very creative, but you might have the need to create a new table from scratch as well. So if you didn't already create the thing that you want to link it to, you can do that here. For us, we're going to go ahead and link to table 2. We're going to link 1 to 2. And a couple things that are going to be important here. Number one, I have to choose a name for this link. If I don't, it will give it an automatic name, something like link to table 2. The other thing I need to choose is, of course, confirming what the field type is. So the field type here was the link to another record. So if I wanted to make any changes, this is the time to do that. Of course, I'm not set in stone. I can always come back later and make changes, but it's easier to get it right the first time. Now, the other thing of note is that when we create a link from A to B, then B is also linked to A. So when we link two things, we're going to see that link in two places. So as soon as we create this field, it will then also appear on the other table, which is why earlier I said we will start the link from either of the two tables that we want to connect together, because all we have to do is establish that link once and it's going to appear in the other place as well. Now we have some other fields or some other filters here that we can go through. And the first one is allowing linking to multiple records. This one's really important, so we're going to come back to it with a deeper dive in just a moment. We also have limit record selection to a view. This allows us to limit the records that we can link to based on a view in Airtable. So this might be a little hard to understand. Let's imagine that you've got a table of contacts. And in your table of contacts, you have contacts who are internal to your organization and contacts who are external. You might create a view in Airtable that says internal. And on that view, it would be only internal people. And then if you had a linked relationship, you might limit the selection just to the internal people. That way, when people go to select a record to link here, they would only be able to select internal contacts on your table. Even though you might have a long list of contacts, they'll only get a subset of those contacts to choose from. Now, it's important to note that they can still actually link, not through the system, but if they had an automation or something that linked them to another contact, it's still possible to link to another contact that's not in that view. But when you limit the record selection to a view, you will be limiting what people see when they are choosing manually in the database. Same thing kind of goes for the filter record selection by a condition. The condition is similar to the view, but it's more dynamic. Because with a condition, we're able to set up rules, for example, that say, only show me contacts that have a last name that starts with P-R-O, or only show me contacts that have an email that is at a particular domain. And so this is very similar to the view, except that we are going to build the conditions for that filter right inside the filter itself, as opposed to in the view. Now, the other option here is to use AI to show top matches when selecting a record. So if we enable this, it will toggle on an AI prompt for us where we get to say, use these fields in table one or table two to map what you think I want in my options. Now, that doesn't mean that you can only select those things. It just means that the AI is going to give you some recommendations on what it thinks you want to link there. And then based on that, you can either choose that or something else. So this is not one that we use a ton, but when we do use it, it's really, really helpful. So these are all of your different options when you're building this link. And do note that these options are available, again, on both sides of the relationship. So when I go to create this field, it's going to create that link to table two. And table two now has a link to table one that did not previously exist. And that's because of the link that I just built. And I can go in on either side of these linked relationships, and I can have the same options here. Now, let's go ahead and take a look at the first one, the allowing linking to multiple records that I promised we would come back to. So, why is this so important? Well, we want to make sure that we get this right. Because if we keep this toggled on in both situations, that is, on both sides of the linked relationship, it might not be the linked relationship we want. So let's take a look at the different options we have. Bear in mind that we have two locations to change this. So let's start by toggling it to a single record. So I am not allowing linking to multiple. And I'm going to go to the other one. Let's pause my alerts for a moment. And I'm going to go over to table one, and I'm going to make the same change here. So on both sides of the linked relationship, I can only link to one thing, which means if I link thing one to link one, when I go over to table two, link one is also linked to thing one. This makes sense. But notice that I cannot add another linked relationship here within this section. Now I can within link two, because link two, my second record, is not yet linked to anything. But if I want to link one to something else, I have to first remove the link to thing one, and then I can choose something else. Let me go with thing two here. Going back here, I've removed the link to thing one, and link one is now connected to thing two. So understand that a change you make in one place is going to be reflected everywhere. This is the beauty of Airtable, because it's real-time data connected, getting all that information, data's talking, it's all synced up. Great. That's great. But bear in mind that a change you make may also have downstream impacts if it's not what you intended to do. Now, the importance of understanding the linked numbers here, allowing two multiple records. What we've established here is called a one-to-one relationship, because on either side of the coin, we have said that you can only link to one thing. This is not used very commonly in full transparency. So we don't very often build these. What would an example be? You know, maybe, for example, a person has a social security number in the United States or a tax ID in many other countries. So when we are working in that capacity, we might say, you know, if we had a table of contacts and then we had a table of tax IDs, then we would have a one-to-one relationship there, because a person only has one and a tax ID only relates to one person. There's really never any other output or option. It's not very common that we would build this, though, because it makes more sense to just include a field. Imagine table one was people, and then we would have just a field for their tax IDs. So it's more common that we would not see that one-to-one linked relationship, but sometimes it does make sense to build. The more common types, though, really is a one-to-many, where we have one table linking to one thing, and table two is linking to many things. So for this, we would see a toggle on to multiple records in one of the tables. So here I've got table one is able to link to multiple things. So I can link thing two to link one and link two, like so. Back here in table two, we're going to see link one and link two both linked to thing two. But notice that I can't link them to more things. They only go in one direction, really. So this might make sense if we had a table of contacts and a table of addresses. So one contact might have multiple addresses or be associated with multiple. But an address might, in this example, only be synced up to one contact. So in this way, we would have a one-to-many relationship. Or if we flipped that around, we could say that a person can only be connected to one address, but an address might be associated with multiple people. So that would be the exact same one-to-many, just turned on its head, and we would have changed the positioning of the links. So the other thing to consider, of course, is a many-to-many, which is pretty straightforward. We toggle on the multiple records on both sides of the equation, and this allows us then to link many things from one to many things on the second table. And just like so, you'll see examples like this, where this is connected to two records, and then over here on table one, this is connected to two records, and so we have the many-to-many. This is used, although it does get a little bit messy sometimes, and so you might see more of the one-to-many relationships, but it really does depend exactly on your scenario and what it is you're building. Now, the last thing I want to talk about is what's called a junction or a join table. So very often in Airtable, if you're trying to build a link between table one and table two, and you're just butting your head up against a wall, you're not able to get the result you want, it's very likely because you need to build a third table. So let me give you an example here. Let's say you have contacts, and then you have their rates, an hourly rate. So contacts could be table one, and then an hourly rate could be table two. And you could imagine that somebody's hourly rate will change over time. Well, if you break the link, let's assume it was, a connection here. If you just erase this link, well, then you're going to lose all of your historical data that has included that person linked to that rate throughout all the different transactions, all the different bills, everything else that you're tracking in your system. You don't want to delete stuff. And so what we would do instead is perhaps build a junction table that allows us to get unique intersections of these two things. So take this as an example. Let's say this is me. I'm Gareth here, and I'm a person in table one, which is contacts. And then in table two, we have rates. And let's say I've got a rate of 80, a rate of 90, and a rate of 100. So rather than building this direct link from Gareth to a link for 80, well, maybe we want to say we have a rates table here that is the unique intersection of rates and contacts. So we'll show you how that goes together pretty quickly. So first I'll build the link to table one, and I'll call this people. And then I'll build the link to table two, and I'll call this one rates, because that's what we're pretending is living in there. Now, both of these relationships in our third table are going to be single on this side of it, on the junction table. So table 3 is the junction table in our example here, and we're going to make sure that they both link to these other tables only one time, or rather only one record at a time. So what I'll see then is I'll get, well, Gareth has the rate of 80. And then here I can say, well, maybe Gareth gets a promotion to a rank of 90. So I could include a new field of like the start date of when that rate went into effect. And now every time that I've got to pay a bill to Gareth that was before that date, I would link it to this first record. And every time I have an example where Gareth is getting paid at the new higher rate, I would link it to this record and bring in the value of the rate from here. So this allows us to build over time and to have, you know, a more dynamic and a more flexible database. So junction tables are very often the missing piece. So just put this feather in the back of your cap and remember, as you're building, if you get stuck, there's a good chance you might want to revisit this and go back and use a junction table. That's it for this video. I know we went pretty quickly, but this is for beginners and there's a lot to cover here for your linking of tables. So I hope you got a ton of value from this. If you did, we'd love it if you could give the video a thumbs up, subscribe to the channel if you like this type of content. And of course, if you have questions that we weren't able to answer here, feel free to swing by our website. We've got a ton of resources available for you there. That's it for this one. Thanks for watching and keep on building.